Hello guys, and welcome to the Elements Cup season number 2. We have the last match of the group stages here, last of the best of ones, here between Elements Pro Gaming and E-Lab. And it's of course all casted by D Swordfish. Nice to meet you guys, that is my name and I'll be your caster for today. Only one match, it's a quick, you know, pull in, pull out kind of thing. But it'll be a fun match regardless, as best of ones are always the craziest. We have Elements Pro Gaming, previously Elements 1, for those of you who don't recognize them. It is the Elements 1 team. The Elements Pro Gaming disbanded, and now they became Elements 1, or Elements 1 became the official team of Elements Pro Gaming. Again, Elements 1 was the tier, or second team, essentially. Similar to have Chinese have second teams and whatnot, and now they're the first team. Cool. And E-Lab, which is, well, I mean, everyone. I mean, E-Lab used to be quite strong a while ago. I believe it, I want to say Estonian, perhaps? Lebanon. Okay. It's Lebanese team. And pretty good. I mean, they contain probably the best player or the most known player is Mage here. Now Black has decided to join the team, apparently, taking the place of Rotom, or Rotom, which used to be playing with them for quite a while. Black, you always used to play. Well, Black has played with them. So has Milan, interestingly enough. But not anymore, right? They're still the captain of the team. GH is still there. CBS and the IXM. Also, the traditional players of the team. So the only big change is Black coming back to the team, taking the place of Rotom, which is nice. And he's not standing, he's actually playing for the team, which is great. Right, that said, let's get right into the draft. Of today. With Elements Pro Game vs. E-Lab, we're going to have Void, Fit, Beastmaster, Invoker, and Isle all banned out. Elder Tyan and Mirana picked up by EPG. Whereas, In the E-Lab side, we have Slardar, the Shadow Demon, Dry Ranger, Quixelis, and Darkseer banned out, and Slardar and Juggernaut picked up. So, Slardar and Juggernaut, powerful combo, everyone knows it, you know, Amplified Damage. I keep calling it Fairy Fire because of Dota 1, that's what the skill used to be called in Warcraft 3, I don't know, that stuck. But the Amplified Damage plus the insane amount of physical damage of a Juggernaut, now you combine it with the Keeper of Light. First of all, double Slithering Crush, or almost double Slithering Crush, you can actually chain them perfectly. Slithering Crush at level 4 stuns for around 2.5 seconds, which is enough for you to actually use a double Slithering Crush. Thus getting a stun for up to 5 seconds, usually around the 4.5 mark, as the Chakra Magic level 4 actually reduces your cooldown by 6 seconds, cooldown of 2 seconds, right? I think it's pretty obvious. Keep a Light, not the best against Oracle, because you can purge off your Monolith, which is very annoying. However, the Oracle can easily be destroyed by the Keeper of Light if picked up an Aether Lance or something of the sort. You know, the Keeper of Light can actually hit from quite far. Even a level 4 Monolith has a pretty huge range of 1,000. It's 600 below the Glimpse, so as you can imagine, not that bad. Now, he's also going to be up against the Mirana Elder Tyan. Not too great against neither of these two heroes, as similar to the Oracle, because none of them are really hurt by the Blinding Light either. But Mirana does suffer quite a lot against the Juggernaut and a lot against the Slardar due to her naturally low HP pool. Easily killed, easily bursted. And the ET for now has a good combo with the Oracle, but again, no big wombo combo. Nothing special for either teams, just solid heroes in general. Strong laning stage for now goes to EPG just due to the Oracle pick. Easy kills in the Slardar early on. But the Caudill and Juggernaut's a classic lane, and they could easily go for a dual tri lane or aggressive tri lane. An aggressive dual lane or an aggressive tri lane, and it all works out. And yeah, Black is playing an E-Lab and used to be play or has played before. Was he don't know? He has played. He was a former player of E-Lab for a while. Once after Team Taker disbanded. Phantom Assassin. Now E-Lab seems to be picking the PA. I mean, Black is gonna be the Black is the question is, I don't know if Black is gonna be their carry or Black is gonna be their mid, because Mage is their mid and Mage most more likely be playing the Phantom Assassin. But it could also be Phantom P or Black PA. Black was playing mid last time we saw him with E-Lab, but then again Mage wasn't with him, so still unsure as to what's gonna happen. Magnus now banned out by EPG. The Magnus, Juggernaut, Magnus, Phantom Assassin combo pretty strong. And E-Lab has run the support Slaughter in the past, so they can always run a offlane Magnus, perhaps. And the Sven banned out by E-Lab. Much more of a normal ban, really, to be fair. For E-Lab now, it would still go for a second support. Powerful combination with Keep the Light. Perhaps a Kunkka? I don't actually love the Kunkka here. It's really good against Bad Rider and, in general, Mirana. But maybe you want to go for something safer like an Ogre Magi with a buff strat. Ogre Magi actually seems pretty good. With a Phantom Assassin, you already have a ranged support, so Ogre Magi becomes your melee support. Pretty strong. Whereas for EPG, you need a carry, right? And for them, good carries against a Slaughter and a Phantom Assassin. Sven would have been quite great, so that was a good ban. The Klinks actually comes to mind as being quite fantastic for APG, but they don't love playing the Klinks. We have seen Swift Ending playing him sometimes. The Dusa similarly comes to mind as being decent. The Yamasash a bit annoying, and the Defusal Blade also a bit annoying. But oh, wow, Elab's going to go for the classic Bounty Hunter. Ogre Magi seems better, but the Bounty helps your melee cores, which is our three of them, not get hided. And Track can always hit together with the amplified damage, so I like that. Good. EBG can still go for the
Slark.
Oh, I was not thinking the Slark. Okay, Slark is fine. Slark is all right, I suppose. Swift Ending likes playing the Slark too. Kind of made after casting so much SEA. I'm kind of in the SEA region right now. Can't really go move back to Europe. I need to cast these EPG tournament for a couple days. Lovely. As per usual, this connection. We'll move on to the proper tournament screen now. I was hoping that I would last the whole loading screen. Apparently loading takes longer than this goddamn intro. But we're back. Hopefully that's good enough. Alright, no black candy mage, they say. Yeah, it's a pity. No black candy mage. I don't know what black is going to play. Yeah, but black is more of a PA player, to be fair, than a juggernaut player. I haven't seen black. I mean, just juggernaut just doesn't do too well, really, in general. Like, that's it. Like, Juggernaut as a farmer, as a complete farmer, doesn't do too well. You kind of want Juggernaut in the kind of carry-ish position, more so. Wow, this is amazing. I just realized Dota closed off on me. Valve, thank you so much. Thank you so much for this, man. All right. Well, hopefully, we're not missing any part of the game. But can't really do much about this. You can see, I mean, Dota's actually being restarted right now because it closed off on me because they're fucking assholes. They can't code a proper game, apparently. The stupid client keeps crashing lately. I mean, they really need to do some resource management, some cleaning. Because it's happening in every single pro game. Every single pro game. It's becoming a bit ridiculous now. Now hoping for some game coming up soon. There it is, G. We're good, apparently. Alright, we're back in the game. Cool. No, luckily we missed nothing. Apparently I wasn't the only one who was having serious issues. So we're back in the game. We're set. And it's Elab versus Lumos Pro Gaming, a best of one. These matchups can get intense. As some people said, if you bet for F10K, Elements is going to have quite a hard time. You're comparing against a Slaughter or Bounty Hunter, chances are that the Elab will get a couple more kills in the early game with a Stifling Dagger, the Amplified Damage. But you do have an ET and Oracle combo. Those guys can do a lot of damage. Saw your aim the other day. Okay, I don't know who he's talking to. Anyway, that's it. Let's get the presentation of the teams before we do anything. Let's present allow me to present myself. My name is D Swordfish. I will be your caster for today. And let's get right into the game. CBS will be playing on the starter in the Raiden side for Elab. He will be their offlaner. The support in this game is going to be EIXN playing the Bounty Hunter. Second support being the Coddle played by GH God. Here in the carry position, we're going to have Black on the Phantom Assassin. So it is going to be Black, Phantom Assassin, and Mage in the mid lane with the Juggernaut. All right. Interesting that you'll run mid lane Jug against Bad Rider. I guess he's alright against Mirana. Yeah, fair enough. I thought they were going to run one of those offensive dual lanes, but yeah. Mid lane jungle against Mirana is better than mid lane PA. Right, that said, on the Dire side, we're going to have Elements Pro Gaming. Mirana played by Badrhari. Jesus, her name. He's going to go in the mid lane. LeBron Dotto will be joining him as the support in the Oracle position, or playing the Oracle. On the Slark, we're going to have Swift Ending in the carry position. The second support being Milan, ex-Elab player 2. On the Elder Titan, and finally Mitch will be playing the Bad Rider in the offlane position. CBS caught out here. That's a good 3-person stun. No pounce just yet because I want to commit too hard to this. And they'll force out a salve, which is fine. But they don't kill him, which is what they were looking for. They force out a salve, force out a stun, and force out a tango. All without sacrificing any of their own farm or heroes, which is pretty good, honestly. And that loading screen, I believe, is from an old set that I got. That is from an old set that I got. I believe I remember. That's why it's called loading screen. Milan, I'll be selected. They should be able to kill him with one last Tiefling Dagger. Has no TP. EXM will just find him. And one last hit for the Bounty Hunter will do the trick. Killing off this Elder Titan early on in the game. Good kill, frankly, by the BH. It's not too normal to see a gank here in the bottom lane. They usually go mid with the Bounty Hunter first, but it's nice that he's doing so. Honestly, the Juggernaut can just win this lane right now. There's no need for the Juggernaut to actually have help. So you help the PA instead, who's going to be fighting the Bad Rider. And since it's the hardest lane anyway, it makes perfect sense. Going to go on to Mage, the Illuminate completely misses. But Mage could be slowed down here by a Stifling Dagger. Now they again hit him with a second Poison Orb hit. Lost the Stifling Dagger. EIXN is very committed, but 7 stacks on black. He has to think twice about going in. EIXN also in trouble. 3 stacks on himself. And Shadow Walk. He's ready. He's safe. No Firefly, because otherwise, with a Firefly, the Bad Rider not only could have gotten out alive perfectly, he also could have killed the PA easily. With 7 stacks, it's too much. You can't actually make it away from the Firefly most of the time. Now Milan, also being harassed considerably. This bounty playing more of a traditional support than anything. And, I mean, I guess that doesn't work too well, especially in the mid lane. They want to get more kills on the Mirana or trying to do something. But with the leap, the bounty can't do much except for harass the Mirana. They consider this a waste, and the lanes are pretty strong for EPG too. In this top lane, the Oracle just denied himself, so they did the bounty. But in this top lane as well, you also have Swift ending versus Slaughter. Slaughter doesn't have too much trouble against melee heroes, especially if you get one level of early dash. But, of course, with the help of the support, Slaughter has to play really safely. Or really safely. They even hit him with the pounce. There is the stop as well onto CBS. He'll be stopped for 2 seconds. 2 seconds not enough though, as he sprints away. Pretty fast here. Hard to kill regardless, especially without a second support there. The fact that they're rotating a second support down bottom is big. Mitch will go down though. Too much. Wow, I forgot completely about that. Yes. Okay, the big technique here is the double Stifling Dagger. Level 6 Chakra Magic, or level 4 Chakra Magic, means 6 second cooldown reduction, means double Stifling Dagger. So once he gets to that level, that PA is going to hurt considerably. They've already gotten 2 kills on the Bad Rider, which is exactly what they're looking for. Now they want to get a kill up in the top lane against CBS. Purifying Flames will burn the fish to a crisp, and that's not a tasty shark. As Badri Hari is being harassed, still has the leap though. So you can't really play Fury and kill him off. You need stuns, and you're not going to get him any on the Bounty Hunter. I mean, a well-timed boomerang and a proper Blade Fury, also cocky play by the Mirana, could potentially lead to her death, but it's hard. It really is. It's almost impossible. I mean, she has to be really dumb and really cocky to actually suffer through that. Yagsan walks through the fire because he don't care. Gonna kill Mitch. No, gonna hit Milan instead. The sticky nape on stacks are gonna start coming out, and hard to justify. Or hard to go in fully and committing, especially when you have 2 heroes or 2 supports that are not too tanky. That's the issue with the Bounty Hunter. He has a surprisingly high armor in the early game, but his HP not too great. He can't dive towers as well as Nightstalker or Ogre Magic can. And that's why they don't commit too far, they don't go through the tower, as they can easily get punished for that. And thus, the Bad Rider will most likely live most of the time. Oh, Mitch, though. If he's found by a hasting EIXN, that could be huge. He walks right through the fire. They don't see him. That's a sentry on him anyway. But Bad Rider will decide to go back to base. Smart choice. He just burned a couple of the creeps. You know, gets a bit of last hits and goes back to base to recover all his mana, all his health. Smart choice. As Black continues to farm. Black, who's not even leading in CS, though. Which is amazing, as it's Black. So if Tending is actually beating him with the Slark. Considering he's been playing much more aggressively. Honestly, Black was the king of CS, but he's not anymore. He plays a much more versatile style, which is fantastic. He's grown a lot as a player. Maybe because he's been casting a lot. I've seen other players, and he's learned from them, perhaps. Or maybe he's just been training a lot. But Black is a much more complete player nowadays. Not only farming as much. I mean, he still has a good amount of farm, obviously. His gold is still pretty decent, but he goes for kills early in the early game, especially. Tries to get some early game kills and slow off in there. Pounds gonna hit CBS, and no time for that stun, as the purifying flames will purify him in death. Now, The model leak onto the Pad Rider, who wants to follow up, try to kill GH. Sticky Napalm is up, but he doesn't want to commit too far. After all, yeah, you need a Stifling Dagger on those creeps. Black, don't miss last. Okay. After all, Sticky Napalm is nice, but the one of the hardest counters to the Bad Rider in the early game, especially without an Oracle, is just a Mono Leak. You know, I love this build. He's probably going to max Chakra Magic, and then I would suggest maxing Mono Leak, because the lower cooldown also helps out a lot against an Oracle with Fortune's End. Consider that Oracle is probably not going to get many levels. It stays at 15 seconds. You stay at 10 seconds. So you at least get 5 seconds of Mono Leak, and that's considering that you're not, you know, that he's constantly purging only that, right? No. Rotation down bottom. Gonna kill Mitch, but not enough vision. Black can do the double, or not even double. Just a single Stifling Dagger. There it goes. 3 second cooldown though. Quite a big Stifling Dagger now. They have to kill off this Milan. Won't be able to kill him off in time. He even goes invisible as he TPs away. And the rotation comes in from Madri Hari. Wants to kill GH. God will hit him with an arrow. That's all they needed to finish him off, really. Quick arrow, Moonstorm, or Starstorm. Boom. Death through. As Bounty Hunter in the top lane wants to use invisibility for similar purposes and getting a kill. However, it seems pretty hard, especially with a sentry around. The sentry can barely see him. If he goes on LeBron or Swift Ending, he could just go down by accident. Especially because the Dark Pact is level 3, so that's a lot of area damage. One pounce, one hit, and one Dark Pact kills off this Bounty Hunter. Nothing he can do. Even if he goes invisible in time, you know, he's at too low a health right now to fight. Has no magic stick either, which puts Bounty Hunter. I mean, magic stick is not the most common of items on a bounty, but oftentimes without it, you actually are less tanky than you think in the early game. Also, yes, sorry, a bit sick. As you can see, my voice is a bit off. But you shouldn't be... It shouldn't be too noticeable, hopefully, in the cast. Oh, it's not too sniffly or anything of the sort. Just a bit. Just have to sneeze a bit. Sometimes it happens. Apologies if it ruins your cast or something. Hopefully it doesn't. Right, CBS comes in as a sprint. Only level 2 sprint. Not that fast. Gotta go fast. But not fast, not that fast. Needs a Blink Dagger really to initiate. Look at the net worth now. You can see that the Black is not that far behind the Slark and or the Marana, neither is the Junk. They're pretty even. But the Slardar and the Batrider have a considerable difference of around 700 gold already. That's a good boot. Maybe not. I mean, Batrider will definitely get his Blink Dagger before this Slardar, regardless if he goes for drums or not. Now Milan in trouble. He's actually used a stun out, but doesn't quite get it. Thanks to the boomerang, stops him. Milan now stunned out. And the IXN has no invisibility. Doesn't want to fight Milan just yet. Have to use it just in time. Dust comes out. In comes Badru Hari. But again, no mana on her either. Body block, not too effective. The IXN, what are you doing? They keep seeing you and walks right through them as he goes down. Probably smelled the Bad Rider and decided to change routes. But didn't work out for him either. Now, it seems like Swift Ending in the top lane wants to go for CBS again. They know where he is. The path's available. CBS, goodbye. Oh, one last Slytherin Crush. They have a Purifying Flames, though. It starts to heal CBS, and it seems like they want to go back on LeBron Dota. Swift Ending now being healed up by the Moonlight Shadow. The Purifying Flames is going to kill CBS. They want to get that final hit off, but they just can't. This Lardar is a bit too tanky. LeBron about to die. Luckily, auto attacks a creep, changes the aggro of the tower, and CBS ends up being healed in that engagement. That magic stick being more useful than they thought. As they go on to him again, they slow him down. Stop him down, but EXN will kill off LeBron Dota in the backlines. As the amplified damage comes in, purges it off. The Omni Touch is available, though, and the Shadow Dance is also there to stop it. No track. Oh, EXN will see him. Almost dies in the Dark Pact. It was only a couple ticks away. Lucky that he evaded that. Meanwhile, this bottom lane. Okay, no attack from them. And here comes the Elder Tide, kills off the Slardar quickly with that spirit. Yep. I mean, getting the Slardar in the end. Black still keeps fighting, but the Purifying Flames will finish off this PA who has a spasm before he dies. Omnis is available. Badri Hari is being stunned out. No mana. The Dust comes in, thinking it's a Bounty Hunter. In fact, what a counterattack going on to Mage, possibly. But there's, again, no mana on this Marana. The Mana Leak so effective. And with that, I mean, Elab had a pretty good start, but now starting to lose a bit of ground against the Slark. You know, but it could always be, this could always be like the Battle of Zombie, you know, in case you guys don't know. That's where Scipio lost a lot of ground back in Africa when they're fighting against Carthage. Ended up losing a lot of ground in the early game. In the early fight. But in the end, the retired Legionnaires actually managed to destroy the enemy team. quite fantastic fight. It's not a Dota fight, it's a historical fight between Rome and Carthage, but you know, analogies are there for a reason. Now, Badri hurry. Oh, spinning wheel, sorry. I thought he was gonna go for the arrow perhaps and get a kill, quick kill, because Mage was playing quite aggressively, but there's no way. Lose a bit of ground, eventually win. And yes, the Fuse Wind up would help a lot actually on the PA. Good comment on the. I don't know if that was what you meant, but good comment on the chat. Thank you, Shade Joker. Because they go, if Black grabs it, would reduce the Purify and Flames damage, means it's not that much of a nuke, and then you can actually still get healed. So if they can't purge it off, they essentially have to get the combos off on the PA to actually deal damage to her. And despite the low cooldown, the Purifying Flames won't be able to do much with it in terms of nuking damage. So getting Infused Rain Drop on PA would be kind of basic, I would say. Now still getting the double Stifling Dag. Oh, not there yet. He actually got reserving that last point, maybe to get a second level of Illuminate. God damn it. I was going to say Monolith, but he's going to go for second level of Illuminate. They are already predicting a loss. The second level of Illuminate will help a bit against defending towers and whatnot, so they're already predicting having to play defensively, and then you do need a couple more levels of Illuminate. Usually you don't want to have to go for that build, but, I mean, pro players do love it. Oh, we extend, dusted out, swift ending, or LeBron? Extend will go down the guns. That was LeBron Donner's dust, by the way. Didn't even take down the ward with him. GH, careful, what are you doing here? I can easily pounce on you any second, you're lucky that was on cooldown. Illuminate keeps coming out, but they will hit GH God. He's been stopped in place. The arrow coming in, and they will finish him off with one last Dark Pact. Swift ending deals way too much burst damage as CBS comes in. Can purge that amplified damage easily. Even prevents any further magical damage going up to him, but he also purges the Fate's Edict LeBron, in case you didn't know that. So that was. You have to be careful with the Dark Pact usage. And yes, no Excalibur. I don't think Excalibur is just a stand in. Black can literally play this. Like Black, now the sticky napalm. There's no flame break to bring him back. CBS comes in. They do have the amplified damage. The XN joining in. And one last crit will finish off this Bat Rider. Now, with that, they do get a bit of an advantage. Black still. I mean, it's not too bad in terms of farm. Considering your PA, he's actually doing decently for himself. Has to find some kills though, needs the Desolator early. They even kill off the starter though with a good arrow. Wow, that is. He turned from shark to flatfish. Oh, yeah, Xen has been dusted. Arrow. They do see him. Even uses a sentry there. See if there's any wards. Yeah, they missed the arrow. Now he knows there are no wards, but finding mage instead. The Astral Spirit. Pretty strong if you get a stun out, but with a track, it's kind of hard to bring down the Juggernaut right now, especially without an arrow. No stun, the track makes it hard for. Pretty much anyone to win, but they have a lot of dispels. The track and the amplified damage both need to be dispelled, but both are easy dispelling, really. You might even see a Diffusal Blade on the Moron at some point just to dispel those abilities. It's not that bad idea, really. You can combine it now with a Slark Dark Pact. They have a lot of dispelling power, a lot of purges essentially, onto themselves, which is not bad. It's a good idea, actually. The draft, is, as far as I'm concerned, the draft against a Caudill, a Slardar, and a Bounty Hunter, all three of which are weak to purges. It's a good idea, as far as they're concerned. I don't know how much the PA and Juggernaut will work out. I mean, particularly... Sorry, not a Caudill. I don't know how well the Juggernaut and PA, though, will do in this draft. They're still pretty relevant, so they're still strong against Elements Pro Gaming. They have their own purges themselves with the Battle Fury and whatnot against the Oracle. But still, I like the Slark pickup. It was smart to go for the Oracle as well. Even if the Slark is a Oh, and they go on to Bitch, and Lasso, Mage will be caught out, they're almost dying, and comes the Slark, so extending with the Dark Pact, will kill off Mage first, then the Kitty, decide to go on GH God instead, Starstorm will blow him right the fuck up, and Black doesn't manage to get away, but for how long, I mean, the Slark has a Shadow Blade, he can initiate whenever he wants to, Black decides to go for the Vanguard, their first item, I mean, I know that turns into Abyssal Blade later, but I don't think that's a great first item. But the amount of magical damage enemy team has, if Black gets fanned out here, Swift Ending will instead go for CBS. Easy kill. In case of Mirana, Starstorm, CBS is lucky that he served his bait. Because otherwise the PA could have died. The Black dying in general would have been atrocious. Now, The issue with the ELAB as well right now is that they're against what ELAB's programming is bringing on is that the bounty hunter is kind of countered by the Slark. Because the Slark always knows when the bounty hunter is around, so he can't serve as a ward because of the Shadow Dance, right? So the Slark thinks, okay, there's either a ward or there's a bounty hunter. If you walk around the same area and there's always a ward, and or there's you walk around a certain area, which is typical warding spot, like say you walk around this area, right? And you're a Slark. You think, okay, there's a ward. But if you walk around, like, this area, for example, you know, like, in the trees, and you and they see you, you know there's a bounty hunter near you, right? Or in this area, and there's a ward, you know there's a bounty hunter near you, right? And that's just because of the vision, because the Shadow Dance will turn up. So the bounty doesn't serve as a ward, or as a moving ward, essentially, which is what bounty hunter is used for often. He's not that moving vision kind of guy. And that puts you at a disadvantage because he loses a lot of the ability he has. Now, jumps will happen on the Mitch, but like I said, he'll get Rems and Blink before the Slaughter gets Blink. This is the Chinese Bad Rider. It's becoming very popular, honestly, going for jumps first, even skipping Lasso often. In SEA, it's a bit more exaggerated. It's always in China. Like, I've seen Bad Rider skipping Lasso even until level 10, even though it's a great skill, just because Firefly and Sticky Napalm are so amazing, and you can get a couple levels of the Flame Brick early on, but you get like 2 levels of Flame Break, 4 levels of Sticky Napalm, 3 of Firefly, so, and then you finally get Lasso level 11. I've seen that before in with drums. You become a powerhouse because you deal a lot of damage in the early game, so they take more advantage of a Bat Rider and then just use those Lasso in the late game. But in EU Dota, where the fights start a bit sooner, it doesn't make much sense to do that. In China and SCA, the fights start like minute 20 is when the big fights start. In EU Dota, minute 15, they're already like, crushing each other or trying to. You know, you're gonna die a lot, so Bat Rider helps a lot more. Let's see, VGH. What do you think you can dispel the TP? Yeah, that's not working out for them. As Milanus in mid lane. Oh, they go. The Slark from behind. There's even an Earth Splitter. Not going to hit CBS, but zones him out a bit. Shadow Dance out. But should have used it halfway through the Omni Slash. That's not going to help. Now, he's to pounce away. He does purge off the track and the Amplify damage. With a Shadow Blade, he should be back on track. Unintended. Milan will be caught out though. Tries to keep you away. Omni Slash available. The Flame Break comes in a bit too late. Does not save him from the Illuminate or the Caudal Blast rather. And oh, that Illuminate level 3. Chakra Magic level 3. Jesus Christ. I don't like this Caudal build. I'd much rather have the... I don't think you should max Illuminate. I think Monolith is often underestimated just because it has such a low cooldown. It doesn't really matter if you purge it similar to how track and amplify damage. Sure, you want to purge it, but it's still a powerful ability. If you get a level 1, it's absolutely useless, because they're going to purge it every single time. It's low cooldown and whatnot. By the way, I think it was obvious, the matter of dying, it was terrible. As per usual, you don't. You can't just lose a game. You have to at least throw for a while, then you should win or lose. Now Black being targeted by a double Star Storm. That was good Aghanim's, but it's not enough to actually finish off Black. They do kill off the Oracle there. And Slark comes in from behind, has the help from Moonlight Shadow. Also Shadow Blade goes on to Mage. Will now find him with a pounce. Has to pounce away himself. As CBS starts to find the kill on the Slark. Amplify damage onto him. He can Dark Pact it out. And the fish will just run away, ironically enough, because he has no legs. Now, I think he has no legs. I think he's slipped, so he has no legs, right? Yeah, it's weird that he sprints, actually. If you think about it, it's weird that I think it's a joke kind of thing. Because how does he sprint if he has... I mean, I guess he just gets wet and then starts going faster, maybe. And yeah, this is called Chinese Bad Rider, by the way, in case you guys didn't know. The build is literally made in China, the drums. It's a great build. I like it, but you know, it was made in China. They were the first people to use it. Chinese Dota, I mean. Not like a... In old times, in the 200 BC, I heard the Bat Rider was theorized with... Nah, fuck that. Not at all like that. I mean, like in Dota. The Chinese team did. That's it. Drums also with a jug. That's not Chinese jug, that's just jug. I don't like the drums too much in jug. Well, as opposed to the Battle Fury or whatever other items you care of. Oh, Blackie being hit by the Earth Splitter. And then pounced on. Good job! At least trying to Phantom Strike away. But Swift Titan keeps the pounce in. Very smart on his part, as he knew the Phantom Strike would come in. And worst case scenario, since you don't hit creeps with the pounce, you can't really block with that. Now Mage with an Omni Slash in 4 seconds. Vladihari doesn't really realize this. Tries to stun him out. The Storm, the second one comes out. Loses a lot in that engagement as Mage will go back. That's an Omni Slash level 2, so he can easily kill off a Mirana. Mage now with a healing ward is healing quite a lot, but the arrow can come in any second. Battery Hurry is still around. The arrow is going to miss completely as they go. Better stop him. The Omnisash will be eaten up by LeBron Dota. And easy kill on the Oracle. As together comes the Slark, Swift Ending, and Battery Hurry. Do they have enough damage to finish him off? Echo Saber to slow him down. But the Blade Fury didn't spell that. And now GH comes in with an Illuminate just to pull up, or to force the enemy team back. As in the top lane, we see Milan fighting EXN alone. He has no mana, so he can't really fight him fully. Even go for the Yule Scepter now. That combo with Yule Scepter and Echo Stomp. Makes sense. The arrow comes out. Hits a lion? A wolf? Yeah, wolf. Sorry, I don't know why I call these lions. Giant wolves. I don't know what the fuck. This is a giant wolf. And this is an alpha wolf. Jeez. I wonder how that big that is. Okay, Slark catches GH, but he just kills it. Yeah. Nothing the Monolith does against the Slark Link. The Dark Prince is too strong. And with that, he gets a couple of agility stacks too. 7. You can fight with the rest of his team now. Battery Hurry being targeted with the amplified damage plus the Tilfling Dagger. It's too much damage onto him, but the leap will help him out. However, Black comes in with a Phantom Strike and destroys him in a matter of seconds. A Swift Ending from behind, still looking for the kill. Ancing for it, in fact, but he has to farm the jungle instead for a while. He's always fighting from behind, so the Shadow Blade can mean a really good initiation. However, E-Lab is not giving up. They're going for this tower now, getting a bit of extra gold. And Juggernaut's finally surpassed the Milan in terms of farm, so has the PA. Only thing left here is Swift Ending, who has a Silver Edge, is looking for Black. The Sentry's there, and he's been amplified damage. Can he dispel this? They use the False Promise. They will finish off CBS in a matter of seconds. Beautiful job by the Oracle. Now Black stuck in the middle of the Earth Splitter, being destroyed by the Stark, who's healed up completely thanks to the False Promise. The Omni Slash fails. It doesn't quite kill the Oracle. Sorry, not the Omnisash. The Juggernaut fails to kill the Oracle, but he will die down himself. One last hit there by the Juggernaut will do the trick. Sorry about that. Bad guess. Yeah, XM will go down to the power of the Echo Saber plus the Silver Edge, I believe. That was triggered. Yeah, seems like it, maybe. Does get him a lot of damage on them. And since the Call of Light early, it's pretty much a team wipe for LS Pro Gaming. And yeah, Shin Joker, that was not supposed to be a Chinese accent. That was supposed to be, that's just racist. That was supposed to be like a historian accent, like one of those joke historians that appear on History Channel. I don't think that was Russian either, to be fair. I think Russian is way too kind of you thinking that was Russian. But cheers. Obviously, yeah, I don't think it's English. Oh, Mage got out. Amplified damage. Also, the Monolith gets an easy stun. Why would you lose Illuminate? Sorry. Yeah, the Infused Rain makes the Illuminate kind of pointless. Now that Desolator coming on the PA. Okay, that's a good time for the lesson. As far as, I mean, it's decent timing considering 22 minutes in. Not bad at all. The Slark has a Silver Edge, so you have to protect somehow against physical attacks, which is why Vanguard is so good. Has allowed the PA to stay alive, more or less. So, in the end, it ended up being a decent pickup. Still not as good as the Jug in general, and has died more times, but at least the Slark can't kill you as easily now. Especially with the Silver Edge. The Silver Edge is still really good because it reduces your damage to 50%, but taking out the Blur is not that big of a deal anymore. Oh. Yeah, kill off the Oracle, or as much in the early game as the Vanguard. But a good stun here. However, that stun will allow for GH got to die. They just let them sleep for a while. Sleep, my sweet baby, they say. The Armistice comes in, hits Swift Ending for a bit. But we'll destroy the Bad Rider now. Both got in the Earth Splitter. Mage and CBS will go down. Mage is trying to TP away, but he won't have enough time. The pounce are coming in from Swift Ending. The Bounty Hunter wants to help, but the pounce actually evades that boomerang. Swift Ending becomes, or uses the Silver Edge again, trying to go through the tower. Black knows he can't be hit if he goes right next to the tower, but he's going to come into this fully. Hits him with Silver Edge, no damage onto Black, and we'll finish him off with the auto-attacking. Now, EIXN is close by, but what can you really do against a Slark who's this farmed at this point? Even use the track to dispel, or even use the Dark Pack to dispel the track. Easy stuff. And Yoz is fantastic on all the time, by the way. Just saw it, but Yulz is fantastic. Consider that the Yulz gives you, like I said, a lot of dispelling, purging abilities, essentially, against the Keeper of Light, the Amplified Damage, and the Track. Great. On top of that, it allows you for the amazing setup stun on the Elder Tyne. It's a really good item. However, Elder Tyne doesn't need to build any items with it. Four Staff or anything of the sort will work out. In this particular match, Yulz is good. I'm glad they just have good optimization. That's all I'm saying. Slark is good to go with this game. Like we mentioned. Swift Ending is too strong right now. He's just gonna snowball out of control. Yusuni, all he needs is to be the Scotty. And then he's gonna be unkillable on top of super strong. You know, so, like, deals a lot of damage. He went for the Passion instead, which is interesting, as it still gives him a bit of HP. He has 2,100 health. And the great thing about getting Silver Edge now is they can actually itemize a bit more versatile, or you can be more diverse with your item choices. Because now the Slark with the Silver Edge extra 15 attributes, which is a lot, that's a lot of extra HP for him. In fact, it's what, a good 240 HP that you get from the strats just from that. And on top of that, you get agility and whatnot. So Silver Edge makes him tanky enough that he doesn't need Scotty necessarily. You know, that's a kind of a vitality booster. So the Basher, you know, can come in a bit earlier. That helps out more against TPs and will help out amazingly against a stupid Juggernaut TP. And, you know, Blade Fury TP. I don't know, Basher is the most traditional item on Slark, and it's better. Maybe MKB would have been a nice choice, but the Basher does give a bit of extra strength, which is always welcome on the Slark. And the Abyssal Blade is pretty good. However, MKB might have been a bit better just for the PA. Still gives you the mini stun, still stops TPs. But you can't stop Juggernaut as easily. Oh, Bad Rider coming with a lasso. His TH gone, but they do stun everyone out. The Armistice hits a couple of them, but Madri Hari will be healed up by the Oracle. Now Swift ending fighting as best he can. The Moonlight Shadow is up, so is the Shadow Dance. The three cores for the enemy team, or two cores, will die. Only one core left, and that's Black on his PA. Can he actually do something against the Slark, though? Who has been decimating the rest of his team. This is like Leatherface, the serial killer, and you're the last... Oh, yeah, he sent that arrow. Fantastic arrow. They're like... This is, Jason. And in the middle of a slasher movie, last girl on the campsite is the PA. But I'm able to defend this tower. They'll just let tier 2 down. A swift ending takes it swiftly. Wanting to find the AXN. They need a gem at this point, probably. Yeah, a gem would be pretty good. I mean, you can know when the baddie hunter's around, but you don't know exactly where he is. You can't really hit him. However, swift ending is more bent on taking this tower than anything. Illuminate even misses. You can't have high ground defense if you miss the Illuminate, obviously. It's kind of hard to hit with the Illuminate, honestly. Swift ending has to spell and that track also to amplify damage. LZ just wants to fight CBS. Is that's not a good idea? Well, eventually just pounce away. Good use of the stifling dagger there, but also good use of the dark pack to take away the slow. Good crit, essentially. Now Murata has the eggs. Eggs is huge on Murata too, but had the eggs a while ago. The blink dagger is also pretty big. The question is what her third item is going to be. Again, I love the purging, so I think maybe... Oh, yeah, Xen caught up with the Slark and killed in a matter of seconds. Now, Murana can go for Diffusal Blade now to get the extra purging. The Yo Scepter's not bad either, and CBS caught out. There goes your initiation, E-Lab, they say, as the Blinding Light comes in, but Slark can just dispel that. Not using the Dark Type, hoping to use it for something better. Black evades that stun just barely with a Phantom Strike. Good play, though. As Illuminate keeps coming in, but they keep healing everyone with the Oracle power. Mage wanted to destroy the illusions. And Slark coming back in. They know they have no sentries, so he doesn't see them. GH God will be wrecked here by Swift Ending. As the PA looking for an angle to initiate, but with a Murana arrow spamming with the Elder Titan, with the banner in general, it looks too hard. They start stacking Napalm onto Black, or onto Mage. Both of them, rather. And they will take down these towers now. That's the Slark, taking down melee, then taking down range. Not towers, barracks really, I suppose. Buildings, essentially. They do catch out the XM with that stun, then the arrow, the Earth Splitter will finish him off. The arrow stun is too big! Three combos and he barely woke up during the whole thing. Swift ending still has the Aegis, by the way, so I wouldn't fight this too hard, Mage, especially with the male Discord looks a bit too scary. Yeah, and Connell is not cool, obviously. CBS will destroy, will be dead there. I don't know what he did there, why he would go into the one lane that's not protected. Oh, Black got out by the lasso, and they want to tear him to shreds. Gonna slice him right up with the Slark Blades, but it's not enough to kill off Black. Now the Yul Scepter to get a setup, the perfect sleep. They get him with the pounce in a couple more seconds. They need to get the Fusel Blade, or the Silver Edge in. Won't kill him off, the pounce hits Mage instead. Easier target, easier kill. Swift Ending will even commit the Shadow Dance to that. And now we'll start hitting the tower. They've lost a Juggernaut, but he has the buyback, so he should be fine. However, Swift Ending, again, still has that Aegis. And they haven't been able to destroy him yet. Ah, Swift Ending is just surviving forever. With the Oracle heals, his own heals even get the Scotty. Yeah, I don't... They leave the Aquila. No. Leave the Aquila. And get the Scotty. And then just go ham. Cut everyone to pieces. They just leave the Aquila, grab the Scotty. Doesn't even keep the courier around because he knows he's gonna finish this before the Aquila is even needed. Top lane, CBS has to push out this lane, but Swift Ending is gonna try to find a kill here. If he finds one on block, that'd be fantastic, but they have the sentries around. They're gonna see him. Shadow Dance goes off. They know that Swift Ending is here. Pounce comes in. Still wanted to kill someone. Loses the Aegis. This is the wrong time to fight Swift Ending. And he dispels both abilities with that Dark Pack. Black in trouble. The lasso comes in as they hit Black hard. The Silver Edge not available, so they can't stop his blur, but they will hit him with an air splitter. Now Black will be pulled back with a flame break. Stark just wants to get the last hit in. They will do so. PA goes down together with the IXN on the Bounty Hunter. That's Scotty. Makes this guy too tanky. Now they go on to Mage Silver Edge. Too much damage. They even use the Yule Scepter to prepare for a good stun out. But the Blade Fear, a bit too hard to fight against. They have no way to stop him. No Abyssal Blade just yet. The E-Blade even comes out on who? The Mirana? Yeah. E-Blade comes out on Mirana. Gonna be pretty weak against the Juggernaut, but really strong against the... PA. Because she doesn't have BKB either. The issue with the new BA build with the Desolator is that it takes quite a while to get that BKB. Before, you just rushed BKB or Battle Fury, and then you got it pretty early. Now you know. Now you get Desolator. And that Desolator doesn't make you farm any faster. Unless you're winning. If you're winning by a lot of Desolator, then you take more towers, so that's a cute, bigger goal for you. Yeah, tower goes down easy. Swift hasn't stolen much agility, really, but with a Scotty, he hits too hard. They're not even tracking him. Look at that. They weren't even expecting a track onto Swift Enemy. It's just a bomb. Dark Bash. Major has been away. TBS comes to the stun. Something can't push it off. But they do help him out. The Shadow Dance not used yet, and they will go to TBS. Can't. Why would you force them away from that? You can't. TBS will go down. The Amatouche comes in. Those Swift Ending is receiving a lot of damage. Use the Shadow Dance finally to heal up and even taking away the Amplify damage. They heal too. They buy back on the Juggernaut. They have to buy back on Black too because he's already dead, but they have no buyback on this hero. And did he use it up earlier? No, just not enough gold. He might have it soon though. 164 gold is quite a lot. Slaughter similarly only needs 26 gold, so they're pretty close to the buyback, but only Mage can use it for now. And he comes back in without an Omnisize, so what can he really do as a Juggernaut who's been completely destroyed here? You know, what is your goal here, Mage? Just keep spinning! Keep spinning as the Slark jumps onto you, finishes you off, and that will bring out the GG, acknowledging you cannot beat Ellis Pro Gaming, who's been on a streak lately. This new team, or this newfound name for them, has allowed them to be amazing team lately. And they destroy ELAB, even Black, even Black's PA, one of his better heroes. They just completely wreck it with the power of the Slark. A great play with Swift Ending in the early game. So amazing pounce shenanigans there we saw with a psychological ability to say, okay, I'm going to hit you hard, but not going to use the pounce in the early game for the extra... Not going to use the pounce in the beginning of the matchup, but we'll use it afterwards to while use the Phantom Strike. We saw that multiple times that the PA's Phantom Strike got punished by a good pounce. So Swift Ending really the star of that game. Right, that's it for today though. No more EPG. The group stages are over for EPG. We'll soon be starting with the brackets tomorrow at 6:30. We will start with the first best of three in the brackets. Still undetermined who's going to reach where. That will be decided tomorrow. Anyway, if you do enjoy the cast, please feel free to follow me on Twitter at the Swordfish. It's at the stream title, and I will also put a link in the stream so you can see. But real quick, so just so you can see how strong the Stark was the whole game. I mean, if you look at the graphs, you can even see player net worth. I don't think he died a single time. Maybe once. No, not a single time. Zero times. He died zero times. His player net worth was on top of everyone's, really. Compare him to... I mean, really, anyone in the enemy team. He never was below them, always leading. Maybe the PA a bit, but he was always leading the whole enemy team. Even compared to his own team, he was leading most of the time. Mirana couldn't even catch up to him at the end. Quite fantastic. Similarly, in player level, also leading. They got a lot of early kills, which was important. Slark oftentimes also killed the PA. I don't know if you can see this. Yeah, three times kills on the PA. Those were the pound shenanigans in the early game. Quite fantastic. In the end, he had a lot of HP anyway. Killed the Coddle a lot. Found him in weird positions. So did the Bounty Hunter. Slark was a good... support killer, and the two supports this time were a bit too squishy. Ogre match, I would have done a better trick. The draft was not that good for ELAB, honestly, against the Slark pick. It was good up until that point. The Slark crushed him. Silver Edge against Black was fantastic pick. Silver Edge against Black, Bastion against Mage, kills the two squishy supports, and CBS can't do much against him because you dispel that amplified damage with Dark Pact. Anyway, that's it for today, guys. Hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you guys tomorrow with the first best of three of this tournament. Until next time.